So one of my jobs as a therapist is to look for patterns and themes in human behavior. And some of these patterns we want to replicate because they're functional. Other patterns we want to try to avoid because they're dysfunctional. But one of the things that I've noticed with guys on the autism spectrum in a relationship with their neurotypical spouse, they're actually having some success with problem solving and conflict resolution. I'm noticing a pattern with them, and they tend to do three things. And I'm speaking in generalities here, but they tend to do the three C's: challenge, commitment, and can-do power. Now, I'll explain what I mean by that. I've noticed that the guys that are having some success, not only in their relationship at home, but also with coworkers and others, they view relationship problems as a challenge, not a problem to be avoided. In fact, quite the opposite. They view it as a problem to approach, because then they can learn from the patterns and themes that they notice. For example, what are their triggers? What is the antecedent to an argument? What happens during and after the argument? And they get to the point where they can avert conflict, which is survival, but they can do one better than that, and that is get into thriving mode, which is, I not only averted an argument, I turned a potential argument into a resolution. We found a solution to the issue. So they view social friction as a challenge. They view it as a problem to approach in order to learn from it, not a problem to avoid. The second C is commitment. And by this, I mean they realize they're going to have to hang in there for the long haul. They're going to have to be patient and consistent and practice, practice, practice. You know, for example, if you were no good at golf and never golfed before and you wanted to golf and you went on the course the first few times, you would suck. And if you really committed to learning this sport because you know it's going to be enjoyable, you wouldn't judge yourself on two or three games and just go, well, hell, I'm no good at this, forget it. You would hang in there, you would practice, practice, you would enjoy the journey, you would enjoy the process, and eventually, after a few months, you'd get pretty good at it, which would be positively reinforcing for you in that you would want to continue. That's what I mean by commitment. Can-do power, what I mean by that is they have a history of getting through challenges and tough times, and it's no different with you. You have a 100% success rate at getting up each morning and facing another day. All of the hell that you've endured, all of the fights that you've engaged in, you made it. You're still standing. Obviously, you have what it takes to get through the anxieties and stresses of the day. So, resolving relationship conflict is no different. It's yet another challenge that you will get through. And not only survive it, but if you follow the lead of these other guys that use the three C's, you get into thriving mode where now your relationship stress has greatly reduced. It's almost down to less than 20% of what it used to be. So in summary, what I'm noticing with these guys that are having some success in their relationships, especially with their NT spouse, is they use the three C's. They don't hide or run from their problems. They approach their problems to use them as learning opportunities, opportunities to look for patterns and themes, namely triggers, antecedents, what goes on during and after. They literally turn it into a game and an investigation. They're committed. They know that everything has to be practiced repeatedly to get any good at it. And they have can-do power, which is confidence that I've gone through so much hell before. Yeah, I'm still standing. There's no reason I can't get through this one.